when I was preparing these remarks, I quite frankly, and my colleagues will understand this, I found myself trying to temper my anger as I was writing it. I'm not joking. I can't fathom what it must have been like. But it's inspiring to see how many of your family have continued as mother's courage to find faith in pain, purpose in pain. That's a remarkable thing, it seems to me. Insisting on an open casket for her murdered and, I might add, maimed and mutilated son. 14 years old. 14 years old. She said, let the people see what I've seen. Let the people see what I have seen. My God. At a time when there are those who seek to ban books, bury history, we're making it clear, crystal clear. While darkness and denialism can hide much, they erase nothing. They can hide, but they erase nothing. We can't just choose to learn what we want to know. We have to learn what we should know. We should know about our country. We should know everything, the good, the bad, the truth of who we are as a nation. That's what great nations do, and we are a great nation. That's what they do. For only with truth comes healing, justice, repair, and another step forward toward forming a more perfect union. We've got a hell of a long way to go. Silence is complicity. I will not be silent, nor will you be silent about what happened.